Welcome back, students. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Your Digital Classroom, where you will get the necessary help for your total English text, grammar, writing, and spoken English all in one. You will get here necessary hints and effective suggestions for your success in the examination at the right time. So don't forget to keep the channel subscribed always. Today you will get the second part of the narration change here. You will learn here the narration change of the assertive sentences. When you finish the video, you will be the brilliant student, jubilant over your success. Now with all your attention, come to the point and see how easy is the lesson today. Our today's topic is narration change, direct speech and indirect speech. Part 2, assertive sentence. In part 1 of this lesson, you have learned that you have to check 5 vital points when you want to change a narration from the direct speech to the indirect speech. If you master these 5 rules, you will be the master of narration change. These 5 rules are about the change of the reporting verb, and number 2 about the selection of a proper corrective, and number 3 about the change of pronouns of the reported speech, and number 4 the change of the verb of the reported speech, and number 5 the change of the other words of the reported speech. Only 5 rules, only 5, and you will be the master of this art. I said out of these 5 rules, the first 2 are the particular rules you have learned, and the last 3 are the general rules. The general rules are the same everywhere, you know, so memorize them very, very well. They are fully discussed in part 1. If you want, go to that video and revise them once again. Here only the first 2 rules will be discussed, because they are not discussed in part 1. And if you are a new learner today, you should always begin the lesson with part 1. Okay, now see, assertive sentence. The first rule, the rule is about the change of a reporting verb in the indirect speech. See how you can change the reporting verb in the indirect speech. If the reporting verb is like this, in this format, he said to me, a to will be thereafter said. If this is the format, change this reporting verb in the indirect speech to told, tell verb in the past tense. See the format, said to. If it is like this, change this format, this verb, to told, past tense of tell verb. Okay, but if it is in this format, that means there is no to after said, then keep it as it is, no change is necessary, you can't change it. Okay, so this is about the reporting verb of the assertive sentence in the indirect speech. Now come to the second rule. The rule is about the connective. In the assertive sentence, you have to use the connective that. Remember this, to connect the 2 speeches, a reporting speech and a reported speech. Okay, here the connective is that. Remember this. So this is the first rule you must learn. If the format is like this, then change the reporting verb in the indirect speech to the tell verb in the proper tense. And if it is in this format, that means the verb is there only without to, keep it as it is, no need of any change. This is about the reporting verb in the indirect speech. And the connective will be that here. Remember this. This is the third rule, it is about the pronoun change. And this is the fourth rule, it is about the change of the reported verb in the indirect speech. And the fifth rule is about the other words change. All these 3 general rules are applied everywhere, here also. So you have to follow rule 1. The rule 1 is about the reporting verb change. Rule 2, the selection of connective. Here you have selected that. And rule 3, the rule about the change of pronouns in the indirect speech. And rule 4, the rule about the reported verb change in the indirect speech. And rule 5, it is about the other words change in the indirect speech. Okay, now see the examples. Example 1, he said to me, I stay here. Now see, come to the first rule. Rule is about the change of the reporting verb in the indirect speech. See the reporting verb format. I told you, if this is in this format, that means there is a to after said, change that one to the tail verb in the appropriate tense. Here it is said to, past tense, so it will be changed to told. See this one. So the first change is the change of the reporting verb in the indirect speech. And number two, second rule is that there will be a connective to connect this reporting speech and this reported speech. See the connective. Connective for the assertive sentence is that. So we have used that here. So this is the second change. And number three, this is the rule about the change of the pronoun in the reported speech, in the indirect speech, indirect narration. Now see, I is the pronoun. I is changed to he, and it is changed according to the number and person of the subject of the reporting speech. You know it very well. So I is here, he. Now come to the fourth rule. That is stay. The rule is about the change of the reported verb in the indirect speech. See, the reported verb is here stay, and it is changed to stayed, because here the verb is in the past tense. If it is past, then the reported verb will be changed to the corresponding past according to the rule 4 you have learnt. Okay, so stay is changed to stayed. This is the fourth change. And number five, this is the rule 5. Rule 5 is saying the rule about the change of the other words in the indirect speech. Is one of the other words, and for this it is changed here from here to there. Why? Because the time and the place of the event are changed in the indirect speech here. So you have got five changes. Here is one, here is one, here is one, here is one, and here is one. All these five rules are working here. Rule about the change of the reporting verb in the indirect speech, rule about the connective, rule about the pronoun, about the reported verb, about the other words. Okay, so your example, he said to me, I stay here. This is the direct narration or direct speech. And the indirect speech is, he told me that he stayed there. This is the indirect narration or indirect speech. See another example. He said, I stay here. See the reporting verb format. There is no to after this. So when this is the format, I told you, you can change this reporting verb in the indirect speech. Keep it as it is. So see, said is said here, no change. So this is the first change. Here is no change. Now the connective, you know, that is the connective. So that has connected the reporting speech and the reported speech. Okay. Now rule 3. Rule 3 is about the rule of the pronoun change. Here I is changed to he according to the number and person of the subject of the reporting speech. Now the rule 4. Rule 4 is about the change of the reported verb with the indirect speech. See, stay is changed to stayed because the reporting verb is here is a past tense. Now number 5, here is changed to there because the time and place of the event are changed here. So here is changed to there. This is your second example. He said, I stay here. This is the direct speech, and its indirect speech is, he said that he stayed there. Okay, these are the examples and the rules you have to use when you want to change a narration of the assertive sentence from the direct speech to the indirect speech. And all these rules are fully discussed in part 1. If necessary, go back to that part 1 and revise the rules once again. Now we'll do some practice and your learning will be perfect. But you must do all the practices for your own perfection. Save your own time and spend it here for your own works and for your own development. Now practice set 1. You know how to do the practice. First, copy the sentences. Copy the question in your copy book. Then pause the video and do the works yourself. When the works are done, come and resume the video and check your answer with my answers and discussion. This is the process and now follow it. Now see the questions. Question number 1. He says, I went there. He says, I went there. Write it down. Question number 2.
He says to me, they helped him.
Within quotation,
they helped him.
Okay. Question number 3. You say, I have taken this. You say, I have taken this. Question number 4. David will say, she has done the work. David will say, she has done the work. And question number 5. John will say, I eat bread. John will say, I eat bread. And question number 6. They will say, we will not go there. They will say, we'll not go there. These are the questions. Now pause the video and do the works yourself. Now see your answer. Practice set 1 answers. First, see the question. He says, I went there. See the answer. He says that he went there. Says, reporting verb is in the present tense, so there will be no change in the reported verb in the indirect speech. The other changes will be held. See, I is changed to he according to the number and person of the subject of the reporting speech. Okay, so he says that he went there. There is no change in the reported verb in the indirect speech as the reporting verb is in the present tense. Okay, this is your answer. Now question number 2. He says to me, they helped him. Again, the reporting verb is in the present tense, but here is 2 after the reporting verb, so it will be changed to the tell verb in the present tense. So he tells me, and that is the connective, you know. So he tells me that they, third person pronoun remains unchanged, so they remains unchanged here. So he tells me that they helped him. Helped, no change of the reported verb in the indirect speech as the reporting verb is in the present tense. So your indirect speech is, he tells me that they helped him. Okay, he tells me that they helped him. Number 3. You say, I have taken this. You say, I have taken this. See the answer. You say that I is changed according to the number and person of the subject of the reporting speech. So it is you now. So you say that you have taken this. This is other word, but it remains unchanged here because the time and place of the event are not changed. For this remains this. There is no change here. Remember this. It is changed when the time and the place of the action are changed in the indirect speech. Here there is no change. For this, there is no change in this word also. So your answer is, you say that you have taken this. Okay. Number 4. David will say, she has done the work. See the answer. David will say, this is the future indefinite tense. The reporting verb is future now. So David will say that she has done the work. has done remains has done, no change, because the reporting verb is in the future tense. You know it. When the reporting verb is in the present or in the future tense, there will be no change in the reported verb in the indirect speech. So the answer is David will say that she has done the work. Okay. Now number 5. John will say, I eat bread. John will say, again the reporting verb is in the future tense. So there will be no change in the reported verb in the indirect speech. And see what happens. John will say that he eats bread. Eat present, it's present, no change. Only one change is here, that is the pronoun change, you know. It is changed according to the number and person of the subject of the reporting speech. So, I is now he. So, your answer is, John will say that he eats bread. Okay. Now, number 6. They will say, will not go there. See, again, the reporting verb is in the future tense. So there will be no change in the reported verb in the indirect speech. See the answer. They will say that, that is the connective. So they will say that, we is now they will not go there. See here, will not go, here will not go. No change. Only one change. The pronoun is changed from we to they. Because the pronoun is changed here, it is the first person pronoun, it is changed according to the number and person of the subject of the reporting speech. So we became they here, and your answer is they will say that they will not go there. These are your answers to the practice set 1. Okay, now come to practice set 2. Here also you do the same, follow the same process. First copy the question in your copy book and then do the works yourself. When the works are done, come and resume the video and check your answers with my answer. Okay, now see the question. He said to me, I like you. He said to me, I like you. Number 2. They said to you, we are going there. They said to you, we are going there. Number 3. You said to them, we have seen you. You said to them, we have seen you. Number 4. David said, I have been reading it. David said, I have been reading it. Number 5. John said, we saw the Taj. We saw the Taj. Taj means the Taj Mahal. Number 6. You said, we were walking together. Number 7. We said, they will come soon. They will come soon. Number 8. You said to me, I shall not help you. I shall not help you. And number 9. He said, I can walk. I can walk. W-A-L-K. And number 10. You said to me, I may solve this. You said to me, I may solve this. These are the few sentences, very simple sentence. Read the sentences and do your works. It will be easy. Okay. Now see the answer. Answer to the practice set 2. Second practice set answers. See the first question. He said to me, I like you. So said to, you know, said to will become told. So he told me that I will be he according to this. So he told me that he liked me. Like is changed to like from present to the past because the reporting verb is in the past tense. So he told me that he liked me. This is the main point here. Like is changed to liked because the reporting verb is in the past tense. Now the second question. They said to you, we are going to you. We are going to you. Now see the answer. They told you that they were going to you. Here it is are going, present continuous tense. And here the reporting verb is in the past tense. So present continuous tense will become past continuous in the indirect speech. And we is the subject, you know. And this we is changed according to the number and person of the subject of the reporting speech. So we is changed to they here. So your answer is they told you that they were going to you. Okay. Number three, you said to
they
them.
They told you
we have seen you. So said to you, no, past tense, and to is there, so it will be told. So you told them. Now one connective, that is that. So you told them that we go there and see, it is second person, so it will be you. So you told them that you have seen, present perfect tense, and it is past, so it will be past perfect tense. Have will be changed to had, so it is had seen. And you, second person pronoun, it will be changed according to the number and person of the object of the reporting speech, so it will become them, and you is changed to them. So your answer is you told them that you had seen them. Okay. Now question number four. David said, I have been reading it. Said, no two is there. So said will stay as said. There will be no change. So David said, and there is a connective that. So David said that I is changed to he according to the number and person of the subject, you know. So David said that he had been reading it. Have been reading, present perfect continuous tense, it will be changed to the past perfect continuous tense, had been reading, because the reporting verb is in the past tense. So your answer is David said that he had been reading it. This is your answer. Very easy. Now question number five. John said, we saw the Taj. So John said, said will remain said because there is no two after it. So John said that we will come here, and it will be changed to they, third person plural number. So John said that they saw is the past indefinite tense and reporting verb is the past tense, so it will be changed to the past perfect tense. See, had seen the Taj. So your answer is John said that they had seen the Taj. They had seen the Taj. Okay. Now see question number six. You said we were walking together. So you said that this one will go there, so it became you. So you said that you were working, past continuous tense will be changed to the past perfect continuous tense when the reporting verb is in the past tense. So it became had been working together. So your answer is you said that you had been working together. Now see question number seven. See question number seven. We said they will come soon. So the answer is we said that they would go. So come will be changed to go here as the time and place of the event are changed. For this, come will become go. So your answer is we said that they would go soon. Will come became would go. The verb is changed here. because the reporting verb is in the past tense, and they is the third person pronoun. For this, it will remain unchanged in the indirect speech. For this, there is no change here. So your answer is, we said that they would go soon. Okay. Now question number 8. You said to me, I shall not help you. Your answer is, you told me, you know, said to, that means told. You told me that I will go there and it will become you. So you told me that you shall not help. It will be will not help, and the past tense of will is would, so it will be would not help, and you means it will be me, so would not help me. Your answer is, you told me that you would not help me. Okay, you would not help me. Here shall not, shall is changed to will, and will is changed to would in past tense, because the reporting verb is in the past tense. Clear? Now question number 9. He said, I can walk. He said, said will remain said. So your answer is, he said that I will become he. So he can will become could, because reporting verb is in the past tense. So he said that he could walk. He said that he could walk. This is your answer to the question number 9. Now question number 10. This is the last question. You said to me, that means you told me, I may solve this. That is the connective. So you told me that I will be you. So you told me that you may will be might, because the reporting verb is in the past tense. So your answer is, you told me that you might solve that. This is the other word. It is changed to that from this, because the time and place of the action of the event are changed here. For this is changed to that. So your answer is, you told me that you might solve that. So these are the answers to your practice set 2, to your second practice set. I think you are enjoying it. Very easy, but very, very useful to illustrate the basic rules of the narration change. Okay. Now we'll go to the next practice. This is also necessary practice. This is also illustration of another rule. Now see, practice set 3. See the question. He said, the earth moves around the sun. He said, the earth moves around the sun. Number 2. The old man said, the old man said, God is everywhere. God is everywhere. This is a direct speech. Number 3. The sage said, the sage said, honesty is the best policy. Number 4. He said, I get up early every day. He said, I get up early every day. Number 5. Mother said, I go to the river in the morning. I go to the river in the morning. And number 6. The teacher said, I learn something new daily. I learn something new daily. So these are the 6 questions. You know what to do. Copy this question in your copy book and pause the video and do your works. When the works are done, come and check your answers with my answers and discussions. They are very, very simple and easy. You can do them easily within a minute. Now see your answer. Answers, practice set 3. Very easy. He said, the earth moves around the sun. The answer is, he said, that the earth moves around the sun. There is no change of the reported verb in the indirect speech, as the reported speech is a statement of a universal truth. For this, this is not changed in the indirect speech, though the reporting verb is in the past tense. When the reporting verb is in the past tense, the verb in the reported speech is changed in the indirect speech to the corresponding past. This is the law. But the exception is that when the reporting verb is in the past tense and the reported speech is the statement of a universal truth or a habitual action, the verb in the reported speech won't be changed in the indirect speech. It will remain as it is. Now see your answer. He said that the earth moves around the sun. There is no change in the reported verb in the indirect speech, as it is the statement of a universal truth. Number two, the old man said, God is everywhere. It is also a statement of a universal truth, so there will be no change of the reported verb in the indirect speech. See, the old man said that God is everywhere. This is your answer. Now question number three, the sage said, honesty is the best policy. This is also a statement of a universal truth, so there will be no change of this verb in the indirect speech. So there is no change. See, the sage said that honesty is the best policy. There is no change of the reported verb in the indirect speech, though the reporting verb is in the past tense, because here the reported speech is a statement of a universal truth. Okay. Now question number four. He said, I get up early every day. A statement of a habitual action. So there will be no change of the tense of the reported verb in the indirect speech. And see, he said that he gets up early every day. Here get up is present. Here gets up is present. No change of tense here, because the reported speech is a statement of a habitual action. So your answer is, he said that he gets up early every day. Question number five. Mother said, I go to the river in the morning. It is also one statement of a habitual action. I go to the river in the morning. So there will be no change of this verb in the indirect speech. See, mother said that she goes to the river in the morning. Here go in the present tense, and here goes in the present tense. There is no change of tense here in the indirect speech. Your answer is, mother said that she goes to the river in the morning. Okay. Now number six, the teacher said, I learned something new daily. So this is also a statement of a habitual action. So there will be no change of this verb in the indirect speech. See the answer. The teacher said that he learns something new daily. See here, learn is present. Here learns present. There is no change of tense here. The answer is, the teacher said that he learns something new daily. So these are the answers to your practice set 3. Now one small practice set, that is practice set 4, and see the question and do the same. Copy these questions in your copy book one by one, then do the works yourself, and when the works are done, come and check your answers with my answers and discussion. The first question, he said to me, I went there yesterday. He said to me, I went there yesterday. Okay. Now, number two, you said, I can do this now. Number two, you said, I can do this now. Number three, they said, we'll come here tomorrow. We'll come here tomorrow. Number four, John said, I'll stay here now. John said, I'll stay here now. Number five, we said, they are not well these days. They are not well these days. these days. Number 6. David said, we left the place 5 days ago. David said, we left the place 5 days ago. Number 7. The girl said, I'll go to school today. The girl said, I'll go to school today. Number 8. The boys said, a thief came last night. The boys said, a thief came last night. These are your questions. Now pause the video and do the works yourself. And when the works are done, come and check your answers. Now take your answers. Now the first question. He said to me, I went there yesterday. Your answer is, he told me that he had gone there the previous day or the day before. Yesterday is changed to the previous day or the day before. This is the change here. And you have learned all about the other changes in the previous set of practice, in the previous practice sets. So your answer is, you told me that he had gone there the previous day or the day before. Yesterday is changed to previous day or the day before. Number 2. You said, I can do this. Your answer is, you said that you could do that. Can is changed to could, and this is changed to that because the time and place of the event are changed here. For this is changed to that. Okay, so your answer is, you said that you could do that. Here this is changed to that. Here yesterday is changed to the previous day or the day before. Number 3. They said, we'll come here tomorrow. See the answer. They said that they would come. They would come. Now next question. They said, we'll come here tomorrow. See the answer. They said that they would go there the next day or the following day. Two changes are here. Come is changed to go, and tomorrow is changed to the next day or the following day. You can use anyone you like. So your answer is, they said that they would go there the next day or the following day. Come is changed to go, and tomorrow is changed to the next day or the following day. Anyone you like. Number 4. John said, I will stay here now. Your answer is, John said that he would stay there then. Two changes. Here is changed to there, and now is changed to then, because the time and place of the event are changed in the indirect speech. For this, these other words are changed in the indirect speech. Here is changed to there, and now is changed to then. This is your answer. John said that he would stay there then. Now see this question. We said, they are not well these days. They are not well these days. Now see the answer. We said that they were not well those days. These is changed to those because the time and place of the event are changed in the indirect speech here. So your answer is, we said that they were not well those days. Okay. Now see this question. David said, we left the place 5 days ago. See the answer. David said that they had left the place 5 days before. So ago is changed to before. Ago is changed to before as the time and place of the event are changed in the indirect speech. So go is changed to before. Okay. So the answer is David said that they had left the place 5 days before. And number 7, the girl said, I'll go to school today. The answer is the girl said that she would go to school that day. Today will be changed to that day. Okay. Because the time and place of the event are changed in the indirect speech. For this, today is changed to that day. The girl said that she would go to school that day. Now see question number 8. The boy said, a thief came here last night. See the answer. The boy said that a thief had gone there the previous night. There are 3 changes here. Came is changed to had gone, and here is changed to there, and last night is changed to the previous night. Okay, because the time and place of the action are changed in the indirect speech. So your answer is the boy said that a thief had gone there the previous night. This is the narration change of the assertive sentences. Here all the rules are carefully practiced with simple and short examples. If you practice these simple examples well, you will soon master the art of narration change in English. When all the types of sentences are learned, I'll give you a special practice lesson where you will get all the different types of English sentences in various forms. You can test your learning easily then. Okay, students, this must today. I'll soon come back with a new lesson on interrogative sentences with all its varieties. All the things will be discussed with easy and simple language. So stay attached, stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell for every new and exciting lesson. Share the videos with your friends and classmates. The channel is helping you. You should do something for the channel. Thank you very much for your patience and participation. See you soon.